Hey guys, it's Libby and I'm here today in a bathroom, if you couldn't tell by the echo and terrible lighting. And yes, this is a penguin nightlight. I hope you like it just as much as me. It's pretty cute. Anyways, today's video is very exciting. It's another wig video, but I think it's gonna be the best one yet because I am dying the wig and it's gonna be super awesome and it might not work out very well, but we will see. And I'm excited, so I hope you guys are excited too. Yes. Before I get into the actual dyeing of the wig though, I should probably just give a brief like review about the wig. This wig is from YS Wigs. It is a human hair wig and it comes with a wig and then also a wig cap and a necklace, so awesome. If you want to know the exact details about this wig as well as like promo code and stuff, I will link that all in the description. But here's the wig. I asked for a blonde wig and the picture they sent me showing it, it looked a bit blonder than this. As you can see, this is just like a medium brown orange sort of shade, but we're gonna make it work. It is a 360 lace wig, which means the lace goes all the way around it. Typically you cut that off, not always, depends on what you're using it for, but yeah. So I finished cutting all the lace off and now I'm just gonna put it on my head to show y'all. However, I'm not gonna dye it on my head because I have trouble keeping wigs on my head. Therefore, I don't think dyeing it on my head is a good idea. Wow, I suck at putting these on. It never gets easier, guys. All right, so the wig is on. I will say that it's super soft and nice. It's a good length and it's not too thick. It doesn't look unnatural or anything like that. But yeah, so awesome wig. Thank you, YS Wigs, for sponsoring this video and sending me this wig. Yep, but I'm gonna get into dyeing it because that's the fun part. Let's do it. So the look I'm going for with this wig is sort of like the sunset look that you see on the internet, you know, like the purple to the red, to the orange to the yellow thing. I think that's super cool. So that's what I'm gonna try to achieve with this here wig right here. Originally, I had wanted to use a purple on the roots. This is Manic Panic Purple Haze. But because the roots are so dark, there's no way it's gonna pick up any of this color. But if you wanna do that on your head, that would be cool. But yeah. The colors I will be using though are these Ion Color Brilliance Brights in the shades Red, Salmon, and Lemon. And I thought, like most hair colors that come in this shape box, because I didn't actually read the box, usually if a hair color comes in a box like this, you need to mix it with a developer. So I purchased a developer for these. Turns out you don't need the developer for these hair colors. They're ready to use. Good thing I used 30 volume on my own head. Not wasted money, yay, okay. Anyways, I was actually hoping though that you would need to use a developer, that way it would help to lift some of the color as I was dyeing it, but that is not the case. And I don't think I should add a developer to this. I don't think that's a good idea. So I'm just gonna put these on there and hope that they take somewhat to this very dark hair. And you know what, if you have hair this color, you will know how these dyes will work on it. So either way, this is a good experiment, I think. Let's get started. All right, so I'm gonna start at the top and work my way to the end, which means I'll be starting with this Ion Color Brilliance Brights in red. Originally, I thought I'd be using a bowl because I thought I was mixing it, but because I'm not, I'm just using my hands, which is super unprofessional, guys. Do this at home. Oh, wow, wow, wow. Look at this technique, guys. Look, oh gosh. I swear, like, if this was on my head, I'd have a better idea of what I'm doing, but because it's not on my head and because I don't have, like, a mannequin head to put this on, I don't have any technique. So I'm just petting it on. Wow. All that matters is the end results, guys. So your technique doesn't matter as long as you get where you're trying to get. You know what I'm saying? Wow, doesn't it kind of look like blood? Oh boy. I'm gonna just keep petting it on for the start. And I know this is not completely saturated or anything. I know, I'm getting there. I'm getting there. I'm just, this is the brief first go. Now I'm just gonna try to get like more all up in there and try to get it like saturated and stuff because that's important. So I'm just like massaging it and stuff. Wow, this is gonna be really bad, guys, but maybe it won't be. Okay, so that is the extent of the red that I'm doing for now. I'm gonna switch my gloves because these obviously have red on them, and then I'm gonna move to the coral. Say goodbye to the bloody hands. Also, pro tip for you guys, a lot of people don't understand when you open a bottle like this and then there's this like silver foily center thing right here. Like, how are you supposed to open that? Oh, look at the inside of the cap. The cap on the inside is a point. So you just flip the cap around, stab it, pull it, it's open. All right, I will say that this salmon is a lot pinker than the box makes it out to seem, but that's okay. I'm not mad. I'll make it work. Wow, this is just literally hot pink. All right. Wow. Ion, you suck. I'm not satisfied with this. So I am not satisfied with the pink color, so I'm just gonna take some of the salmon, and then I'm gonna take some of the lemon that I bought as well and mix that together. All right, so here's a much better orange color. Actually, in the camera, it doesn't really look too orange, but I promise in real life, it's orange. So let's do this. I would say, by the way, the ratio that I mix it out is about 1:1 for the pink and the yellow, by the way. Obviously, it's okay and probably good if you make your red and your orange overlap to help with the ombre look that you're going for. So you probably want to make them overlap a bit and like rub it together and stuff like that. Wow, this is a lot harder the further down you go. Oh boy. You want to make sure you get all the parts, but I'm running out of orange, so. And now I'm done with the orange. And I've got another pro tip for you guys, the correct way to remove dirty gloves, whether it's dirty because of dye or blood or I don't know what else, but I learned this in a first aid class. So what you do is like you ball this hand up into a fist and you grab the edge of it and you flip it off so that it comes off inside out, right? And then you hold it in this one and you do the same thing. So that means whatever is on the glove is like inside of here, and it's like a nice little package and it's sanitary and it won't get your trash can dirty. You're welcome. Now I'm going to take the remaining yellow and use that on the ends. Not sure how well it'll pick up. I mean, it looks all right like this right here. So we'll see. These tubes have more dye in them than you would expect, I swear. Again, you wanna just blend that into the orange some just to make it all flow nicely. I'm actually gonna take a little bit of the pink though because I think I overdid it. And go back over the top again. This is not a science, guys, this is art. It doesn't have to be perfect. We're just trying to get something sort of like a sunset. And if we accomplish that, then we're good. I'm gonna just flip it like a pancake and keep going with the yellow on like the inside. I'm also just gonna grab a bit of the red when I notice spots that I missed. So like at this point, I'm kind of just like doing touch-ups, trying to make everything really vibrant, try to fix any spots that I missed, really get it all up in there. Ah. Rip. But yeah, I mean, that is the extent of the dyeing portion. I'm gonna let this sit for a while, whatever it says on the box. It's probably 30-40 minutes. I'm also gonna hit it with some heat because there isn't a developer in it. That's not gonna hurt it. It's just gonna help to enhance the colors and the vibrancy, hopefully make it pop a bit more since this wig was pretty dark to begin with. But we will see. After it sits for 30 minutes and I throw some heat on it for maybe like 5 or so, I don't know, I will wash it out and I will show it to y'all. Alright guys, so here's the wig all washed out. Obviously it's still wet and so it looks extra dark on the camera especially. Can't really tell what the colors look like. I'm gonna see if a flashlight helps. Not at all, you can't even tell. Alright, so I'm gonna let this dry and then I will show you it when it's dry to see how the colors turned out. Yay! Alright, so Is the hair completely dry? No, it is not. But I have limited patience when it comes to blow drying hair. Also, blow drying this hair makes it super frizzy, which is fun. So I just decided to stop where it reached this point. So as you will notice, the red did take. It actually looks fairly pink, but I would probably credit that to the nice orange base it started on. The orange did take in some spots. I think it kind of blended into the red a lot, so it's hard to just pick out some of the straight orange. Also, my camera doesn't do much justice, but like in here there's some orange. I don't know, you probably can't tell. But as you can see, the yellow did not take at all. This is just like the wig's natural color. But I think that it still kind of has an ombre sunset look. So if you're curious about dyeing this shade of hair, know that red will work, orange will also work, yellow, it won't work. But yeah, so as far as the Ion dyes, awesome. They're not sponsoring me, but I liked them a lot. And as far as the wig, it is dyeable. Is it blonde like I ordered? Nah. But yeah, I guess I'll just put it on to conclude the video. I don't have a hairnet on, that's fine. Hairnet, is that what it's called? A wig cap, that's what I'm looking for. It's wet, the wig cap. Okay, you know what, I'm not gonna put it on, guys. It's fine. So I hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you learned something from my DIY at home techniques for dyeing hair. Hope you enjoy the video though. And again, thank you YS Wigs for sponsorship in this video. Yeah.